how we got started on it is I was part of the National 4-H GIS GPS tech team out in San Diego in 2009. And with that project, or what we did out in San Diego, is we worked with the Fish and Wildlife Service out there.
We got a call out of the blue from Jay Staker, who said he was working with 4-H groups and they had a grant to work on National Wildlife Refuge. We got excited about it because they wanted to do GIS work and GPS, and that's one of the things we really need more of here.
This thumb, the area you're going to be working in is right here.
We're mapping trees at the Wildwood Life Preserve that are native to being here for about 150 plus years.
The project with the 4-H is the woods behind us have remnant bur oak and shagbark hickory trees that have been encroached, invaded by exotic, non-fire tolerant trees.
We are using an iPhone with the ArcGIS app.
If I hit the button that looks like the wrench and then collect data, it's a tree, so I'll hit tree.
Now we have an iPhone app that talks with the ISU GIS department server, and so we get real-time interaction.
We are the only group that is using the iPhone technology to collect data as a test. So we will be comparing using Garmin's, using Juno's, and using the iPhone technology to see accuracy, how easy it is to collect.
I think what's cool about this project is that we actually get to use technology and that we also get out in the field, we get experience.
I think it's interesting because you have to learn the different types of trees and go out and mark them, and it's cool to do with the GPSs and all the technology and kind of restoring something old with something new.
Well, I think it's a great opportunity for the youth in the 4-H club to get some experience out here and to learn a little bit. They're learning the tree identification and just learning the kind of things that happen on a wildlife refuge.
I think it's really important to get students involved doing GIS and GPS activities early on in their careers.
4-H has had a really good partnership with Fish and Wildlife Service for some time, and geospatial is just making that so much better.